Rather sensibly, some children are taught from a young age that they should call 911 during emergencies. So, when Aaliyah Garrett found herself in need of help, she did just that. When a sheriff's deputy came to the little girl's door, however, the officer was presented with a situation that she may not have been expecting. And Aaliyah, from South Carolina, was being supervised by her grandfather when she had made the call to the authorities. Nevertheless, the two-year-old found herself in a situation that she thought could only be solved by the emergency services. As a result, she dialed 911 and was duly connected to dispatchers in Greenville County. That call was made on March 2, 2016. The nature of the incident was initially unclear, however, as Aaliyah had trouble explaining her situation. She could only babble, and her words made no sense to the individual on the other end of the phone. Perhaps, then, it was a prank call, or simply an accident. Certainly, it wouldn't have been unusual for this to have happened. Greenville County had had more than its fair share of unintentional 911 calls in the past. Still, an officer had to be sent out to the scene to investigate, just in case. Luckily for Aaliyah, Deputy Martha Lones was in the area. She took it upon herself, then, to make her way to the little girl's home. Aaliyah's grandfather would be the one who answered the knock at the door, however, and the man was baffled by the arrival of Lones, since he wasn't aware that her presence was needed. He also hadn't realized that Aaliyah had made any phone calls, especially not one to the police. While he and the officer were talking, though, the two-year-old herself made an appearance. Aaliyah had emerged waving to Lones while struggling to dress herself. In a 2016 interview with WSPA, the officer recalled, "The door opened up, and, Aaliyah, comes running out to the front with half a pant leg on, and she's just like, 'Hey!'" Then the true nature of the emergency became apparent. Aaliyah simply couldn't get her pants on. Rather than turn back, though, Lones decided to deal with the situation at hand. As a result, the officer placed herself down on the steps and aided the toddler in her mission to get dressed. Once the pants were successfully on, however, Lones went above and beyond the call of duty. Aaliyah had shoes to put on, too, and so the willing member of law enforcement lent a hand with tying up the little girl's footwear. Lones' hard work did not go unrewarded, though. After she had helped the toddler in her hour of need, Aaliyah gave her a hug. What's more, the officer was far from annoyed at being called out on such an errand. Indeed, in a 2016 interview with WHNS, she revealed, "It was the highlight of my day, and I loved it." And Lones went as far as to persuade her superior officers to share the story on Facebook. From there, the tale of Aaliyah's 911 call went further. It was even subsequently picked up by media outlets across the world. Greenville County Sheriff's Office was happy for the news to spread, too. In a subsequent Facebook post, the law enforcement agency said, "We are thankful when good things that officers do every single day get recognized." Lones got her credit as well, not least from Deputy Michael Douglas, who is also from Greenville County Sheriff's Office. Douglas sang Lones' praises after the incident, telling Inside Edition, "You can't train the heart, charisma or angle she took on this." He added, "We try to recruit those natural attributes." But though Lones was happy enough to attend to Aaliyah's needs, she nevertheless talked to Inside Edition about the importance of teaching kids when it's appropriate to call 911. She told the show, "We normally sit them down and say, 'Hey, this is for emergencies only.'" Aaliyah was spared from such a lecture, however, because of her young age. And Lones was not frustrated by Aaliyah's call at all. It even reminded her of her own childhood. She revealed to Inside Edition that as a kid, she had been fascinated by cops, adding, "I was the little girl dialing 911 just so I could see police officers show up at my house." What's more, given that Aaliyah was only a toddler, Lones declared herself impressed that she could dial at all. Certainly, though, Aaliyah is not the only person to have rung 911 by mistake. In 2015, for instance, over 250,000 such calls were accidentally made in Greenville County alone. When news of the story reached Aaliyah's mother, Pebbles Ryan, however, she was shocked to discover that law enforcement had turned up to her home. Then, when she had discovered the truth, she had laughed. Ryan subsequently explained to Inside Edition that while she had always taught Aaliyah to call 911 in emergencies, she didn't know the toddler would take it to that extent. Ryan also saw the funny side when she shared the story on Facebook, saying, "Well, my youngest baby Aaliyah decided to call the police on my dad while I was at work. They thought she was so cute when they pulled up. They helped her finish putting her pants on, and she decided she had to hug them all. They decided to put her on the news tonight. What will she do next?" And Ryan would additionally tell Inside Edition that her daughter now has a new friend for life. Certainly, it seems as if the pair have made a connection, since the show's coverage of the story sees Lones picking Aaliyah up and swinging her around, much to the little girl's delight. A few days after the 911 call, Aaliyah was reunited with her buddy, too, as Lones went back to the house to film an interview. On that occasion, Aaliyah was wearing a different pair of pants. These, she assured WSPA, were a lot less hassle to pull on. Indeed, Aaliyah's mom took the opportunity to assure Inside Edition that her daughter is normally able to dress herself. Here's hoping, then, that the little girl will have no further wardrobe emergencies, none that require calling the cops, at least.